Hello everyone and thank you for joining us. Today I'll be taking you through Bedfont's recommendations for reintroducing your Smokerlyzer devices to services after the COVID-19 pandemic. Now following this webinar, if you do have any questions, please direct them by email to clinical@bedfont.com. That email address again is clinical@bedfont.com. Now, since the start of the pandemic, infection control, quite rightly, has been a focus for many services using face-to-face CO monitoring. And with CO monitoring being a breath analysis procedure and COVID-19 being a respiratory illness, government bodies took the very difficult decision to temporarily suspend these services due to the unpredictable nature of the virus and unknown risk associated with CO monitoring. Now, since this suspension in CO monitoring, Bedfont have been working tirelessly to restore confidence in CO monitoring. Now, as you can imagine, the first thing Bedfont have done in response to COVID was to look at our existing infection control measures and how effective these measures are against COVID-19. SteriTouch technology has been incorporated within our professional range of Smokerlyzer CO monitors for some time now. And for those that don't know, it is an additive in the plastic casing of the device, which provides an unfavorable environment for microbes to thrive on, reducing cross-infection. In addition to SteriTouch, our CO monitors are used in conjunction with mouthpiece filters, our most popular filter being the D-piece, which incorporates a one-way valve and an infection control filter, which has been tested independently by Public Health England to show it removes and traps up to 99% and 97% of airborne bacteria and viruses respectively. Now, Bedfont recommends that the DPs can be used for a continuous 30 days in conjunction with single-patient use SteriBreath mouthpieces. Alternatively, you could opt for the single-use one-breath mouthpiece, which contains a one-way valve and has been proven to remove and trap 99% and 97% of airborne bacteria and viruses, respectively. Now, as standard, Bedfont provide infection control maintenance guidance with our Smokerlyzer documents outlining best infection control practices Bedfont recommend with their CO monitors. However, it is important to note that this is only a guidance document, and first and foremost, you should follow your local policies and procedures. So what have Bedfont been doing in response to COVID-19? Well, as previously mentioned, Bedfont have been working tirelessly to help support the reintroduction of CO monitoring into services. This has involved close collaboration and consultation with key global government bodies whilst trying to develop a safe solution to reintroduce CO monitoring to stop smoking services. With government bodies and other key opinion leaders, Bedfont created a COVID-19 risk assessment which looked at potential risks arising from introducing face-to-face CO monitoring and how we could potentially mitigate those risks. From this, we were able to determine risk arising from face-to-face CO monitoring could be reduced, and the benefits of reintroducing CO monitoring far outweighed the risk of not introducing CO monitoring back into service. Bedfont have also developed a dedicated FAQ coronavirus page, which you can find on our website at www.bedfont.com. It contains the most up-to-date advice from Bedfont and our recommendations on resuming breath testing with our monitors safely. Now, although Bedfont have done our utmost to incorporate the most consistent infection control guidance globally, we do recommend you follow your local infection control policies and guidance. Now, in addition to this, extensive research has investigated the effectiveness of our mouthpieces against COVID-19. Now, both the D-piece and one-breath mouthpiece filter have been tested to filter viruses as small as 24 nanometers in diameter. Now, to put this into perspective, the COVID-19 virus particle is approximately 125 nanometers in size. And the model virus used to test our mouthpiece filters is approximately 24 to 26 nanometers in size. Therefore, it's fair to assume that the D-piece and one-breath mouthpiece filter are highly effective in removing more than 99% of bacteria pathogens and more than 97% of viral pathogens, including the COVID-19 virus. Now, it's important to note that due to the risky nature of testing live respiratory viruses, a non-pathogenic virus model is used, known as a M2 coliphage. The filters undergo both bacterial filter efficiency and viral filtration efficiency. The virus model is incredibly penetrable, even more so than the majority of human viruses, therefore making it a very effective model to use for virus filtration efficiency testing. In addition to effectiveness of the filter in our mouthpieces, an extensive vigilance and literature review was conducted by Bedfont, looking into the risk of CO breath testing procedure and the risk of cross-infection. There have been no reports of coughing experienced from the use of any of Bedfont Scientific's breath analysis products. The recent clinical studies and all usability studies performed to date examining the monitor's safety and performance show that there have been no coughing-related events. Furthermore, the breath testing procedures for all of Bedfont's monitors do not require patients to forcefully exhale, only to gently exhale at a steady pace until the test is complete. For this reason, completing a CO breath test on a Bedfont Smokerlyzer device is not considered as an AGP. This conclusion is also supported by Public Health England. Bedfont have also developed a series of resources to help get CO breath testing services up and running again. This includes guidance on infection control procedures, recommended PPE, and guidance on calibrating your CO monitor before reintroducing CO monitoring back into your service. Now, to access these guides and videos, you can click on the below link on the presentation or access them on our website under the title Ready to Resume Breath Testing. In addition to these resources, Bedfont recognised the gap CO monitoring left when services were suspended. In response, we developed our new ICO Quit Monitor, a monitor that patients can use in the comfort of their own homes, allowing your patients the tools to continue stop smoking support remotely. To get more information on this, you can visit the dedicated ICO Quit website at icoquit.com or speak to your local distributor. Now, due to an ever-increasing need for healthcare professionals to use alcohol hand sanitizers in response to COVID, extensive testing was performed by Bedfont to determine the effect hand sanitizer had on Smokerlyzer devices. Now, results indicated that alcohol hand sanitizer containing up to 73.5% alcohol once fully dried on hands can be used. However, alcohol hand sanitizers containing more than 73.5% alcohol should be avoided due to the lack of testing with regard to the impact it could have on CO readings. In addition to impact hand sanitizer has on our CO monitors, we investigated the effectiveness of our recommended cleaning wipes for our devices against COVID-19. The Azo Max Universal Wipes manufacturer Vernacare released a statement informing customers that their cleaning solution has been tested against a feline version of coronavirus, a surrogate coronavirus for SARS-CoV-2. Therefore, it would be reasonable to imply that their product would be effective against COVID-19. In addition to this, and to increase choice to our customers, a variety of different cleaning solutions shown to be effective against COVID-19 was tested for compatibility with our Smokerlyzer monitors. Two alternative cleaning solutions were tested on our monitors. 0.5% sodium hypochlorite solution, found to be effective against COVID-19 and readily available in hospitals and clinics, was tested for compatibility with our monitors. This solution has a negligible effect on CO readings and therefore can be used to clean the external surfaces of our CO monitors. Next, we tested the Clinell Universal Wipes, the non-alcoholic version, and that also too was found to be effective against COVID-19 and is readily available in hospitals and clinics. This solution was also found to have a negligible effect on CO readings and therefore can be used to clean the external surfaces of our CO monitors. Now, our professional range of Smokerlyzer devices, including the Pico, Pico Baby and Micro Smokerlyzers, as standard, do not require calibration for 5 years. However, we live in unprecedented times and your Smokerlyzer device has quite probably been lying dormant for long periods. Therefore, Bedfont is recommending calibration and a firmware upgrade before reintroducing them to service. Now, at the time of this recording, the most current firmware version is 2.37. It's important to bear in mind, Smokerlyzer devices approaching a manufacturing date greater than 5 years old will get a maintenance reminder. This is because the CO sensor has reached the manufacturer's expected lifetime. Therefore, maintenance of the device, including a sensor change, is recommended. As Bedfont are recommending you to calibrate your device, we've put together a short guide on how to do this. You can view this by clicking on the link below in the description. Alternatively, you can access this document via the website at www.bedfont.com. If you do not have access to a calibration kit and do not wish to purchase one, you can send your device back to your distributor or Bedfont for servicing, but please note this is a chargeable service. The YouTube link as shown here will take you to the full demonstration video of how to calibrate your device. The link will also be in the description below. The video in particular demonstrates the Pico monitor being calibrated, but the same procedure can also be applied to the Micro and Pico Baby devices. So COVID-19 has meant we have had to adapt quickly to ever-changing environments. This includes adapting infection control procedures to ensure effectiveness against COVID-19. This has meant stronger chemicals being used and more frequent cleaning of areas and devices taking place. It is important to consider factors that can potentially impact on the performance of your CO monitor. Alcohol and bleach vapors, to name a few, can have a significant impact on the performance of your CO monitor. Please ensure your device is stored as instructed in our manual and ensure the device is not being stored around bleach or alcohol. Now, we understand using alcohol and bleach products may be unavoidable currently. However, please remove your CO monitor from this area and ensure this area is well ventilated before reintroducing your device. Now, as we mentioned earlier on, hand sanitizer containing 73.5% alcohol or less can be used. However, please ensure your hands have fully dried and you do not apply the hand sanitizer on or around the device. For Smokerlyzer and Toxco devices, ensure that your D-piece is changed every 30 days. Alternatively, the single-use one breath can be used for increased infection control. So very important question here, will persistent cleaning of the device cause erroneous readings? Well, Bedfont have conducted testing due to increased cleaning of the devices in response to COVID-19 and the stress it may put on our devices. Now, over 80 tests were performed in a short period of time on a number of devices. The devices were saturated in recommended solutions. The results did not cause any significantly high erroneous readings, and therefore we can conclude that increased cleaning of the device will not have an impact on performance. So as previously mentioned, you may experience a maintenance reminder for the first time. The Smokerlyzer devices, as we know, are calibration free and guaranteed for a period of 5 years. After which, we recommend the sensor is replaced as it has reached its expected lifetime, and therefore, at this point, you'll be presented with a warning on screen to replace the sensor. Now, there are a few things that you can do if you experience this issue. You can either go ahead and replace the sensor, calibrate the device as instructed in the presentation, or if the device is outside its guarantee period anyway, it may be more cost-effective and convenient to purchase a brand new device, where it will be calibration free and guaranteed for 5 years. So Bedfont have had a few inquiries and reports regarding devices reading incorrectly, and we have found some users have been calibrating with ambient air. This ultimately has resulted in inaccurate calibration and, as a result, erroneous readings. Therefore, Bedfont recommend using gas for an accurate calibration. It is important to note you do not calibrate devices around alcohol VOCs, as this can result in an inaccurate calibration. Now, we understand now more than ever that hospitals and clinics have adopted very stringent cleaning practices which require the use of certain products and may affect the performance of CO monitors. It is incredibly important that when we use these products, especially products containing bleach and alcohol, that you do not directly apply these products or clean with these products near your device, and that after cleaning, these areas are well ventilated to ensure the CO monitor's performance is not affected. In an ideal world, an electrochemical sensor would only respond to the gas it is targeted to monitor. So for example, a carbon monoxide or CO sensor would only detect CO. In reality, this is not the case, and although electrochemical sensors are designed to be as specific as possible, most will respond in some manner to gases other than the target gas. This is commonly referred to as cross-sensitivity and is a result of the interfering gas also reacting on the sensor electrode. CO electrochemical sensors react not only to CO that is present, but also alcohol. This cross-sensitivity can result in a positive reaction. This means that you can potentially see CO readings increasing, giving you the impression that there is more CO present than there actually is. In some cases, Bedfont have seen readings in excess of 70 parts per million from non-smokers when the device have been exposed to high concentrations of alcohol. The CO sensor will usually recover in fresh air without permanent damage. However, this is depending on the concentration of alcohol exposed to the sensor. The higher the concentration, the longer the exposure time, the longer it will take the sensor to recover. And in some cases, this can be overnight. And in some rare cases, the sensor will not recover and continue to read incorrectly. And if you feel like your device is not recovering or reading incorrectly, we advise getting in contact with your local distributor or Bedfont for further advice. So as previously discussed, this can cause the device to display erroneous readings. It's important you allow the device sufficient time to recover in fresh air, away from any VOCs. Sufficient recovery time isn't an exact science and is dependent on what VOC the sensor has been exposed to, the concentration of the VOC, and the duration of the exposure. And if the device has not recovered after 24 hours have elapsed, we recommend you contact your distributor or Bedfont. So that concludes the end of our presentation, and a big thank you for joining us today. Now, if you do have any further questions or inquiries that we haven't quite covered in this presentation, please do send your inquiries via email to clinical@bedfont.com. That email address again is clinical@bedfont.com. Thank you very much for watching. Take care and stay safe.